Hello. Give me just a moment to get my microphone positioned. It's basically possible for me to stream with my fan still pointing at me, and it doesn't cause too much noise as long as the wind isn't blowing directly into the microphone. Like, right now, this seems okay. Which is good, because I like having a fan blowing on me pretty much anytime I'm indoors. I like wind and air and moving air. So probably going to stream for a couple hours before bed here. An after work stream instead of a before work stream. What was I doing? Alright, Good Springs, Saloon, right, so last time I was debating if I want to do one of these quests, because I kind of need some levels. I looked up some just general tips for unarmed characters in this game, and it looks like once I start hitting like level 8-ish, then I will have access to some perks that should help me out a lot. What is this? Rescue captives. I don't even remember what this quest is or who gave it to me. Booted. Yeah, I don't remember what that is. So I made two major changes to the stream since the last one. The first change is that I enabled the low latency beta thing on Twitch. At least I hope I did. I'm pretty sure all I had to do was opt into it on the website. I don't think there was anything I had to change in OBS. I don't know. If anyone wants to watch live, then they will be able to confirm or deny that. I feel like I already did some inventory management. I'm not sure why some of this stuff is back in my inventory. I saved after maybe it's because I chose continue rather than load. So it loaded my autosave instead of my manual save. No, I still have all this stuff. Weird. I thought I already dumped a lot of this, but oh well. I think I might go see what this Rescue the Captive stuff is about. I don't remember getting that quest. And this stuff I can just sell. Actually, most of this I can probably sell, right? I thought I did all the buy-in and sell-in I needed to before I saved, but apparently not. Looking to buy some supplies? Candy. Boy, he has a lot of caps. Wait. Okay. okay, apparently I can't sell this ammo.
You looking to buy some supplies?
I don't even have an ammo section here, and it's not showing up in my main items list. I don't know what the deal is with this game sometimes. So, I'll just drop it. Oh yeah, the other change I made was that I removed that song from the playlist. The one that's kind of funny, but also kind of annoying, that goes, etc. Oh, would he not buy it because it was stolen? Weird. Oh well, anyway. That song's pretty funny, like I said, the first time you hear it, but after that. Oh, so this... Oh, never mind. Yeah, I don't know what this location is or what this quest is, so I'm going to try to check it out. I guess my best option right now would be heading to Nipton and then following the road. Because rescuing captives sounds like something I should be able to do. Maybe. Because that implies that my enemies will be humans, which are a lot less deadly to me right now than some other enemies I could potentially be facing. I listened to my previous stream and the audio balance was actually really good. I was kind of winging it because I wasn't wearing headphones or anything, but the music and the in-game sounds and my voice all seemed to mesh together pretty well. And I'm glad that I'm finally starting to figure out some of this audio stuff. It's complicated. You wouldn't think it would be that complicated. But there's like a billion different kinds of microphones and they all work completely different from each other. Well, so much for following the road. Or the tracks, I guess, not the road. Luckily, I have a Blue Yeti, which is a very common microphone for podcasting and general YouTubing. So there's a lot of good information about it out there. My voice was clipping pretty badly for a while, but I think I figured out what settings I need to make that not happen. At least I hope so. Sounds fine to me. But you can never really be a good judge of your own voice. Like, I have no idea what my voice sounds like to other people. What's all this? Oh boy, I'm very thirsty. I'm a thirsty boy. Do I have any purified water? That would be the best. No. Okay, well, I'll drink some dirty water. I'm not above it. And my radiation levels are still manageable. And I have plenty of Rad-X and Rad-Away for if my radiation level becomes unmanageable. Luckily, I think having a very high endurance is one of the things of... You know, radiation is one of the things a high endurance helps with. More so than thirst and hunger. Everyone tends to get hungry and thirsty at pretty much the same rate, but having a high endurance makes me much more durable to radiation, I think. Alright. Need to remember my hot buttons here. Do I have any... I should probably put my super stem pack on something. And then do I have any long ranged weapons? Okay, I'll put that on my right D-pad there, and okay. Alright, did I manage not to get poisoned? That would be nice. Good. Bark scorpions, not as much of a threat as they used to be. One-on-one, anyway. Honestly, being poisoned mostly sucks just because it makes it hard to see anything. Because your vision gets all blurry and it's disorienting. Whoa. Got a ground scorpion over here. Oh, Bethesda games. Or Bethesda engines, I should say. I consider this a Bethesda game the same way the tomato is a vegetable culinarily, even if it's technically a fruit. People consider it a vegetable for cooking purposes. Or I guess a better analogy might be maybe I should have been following a road. Okay, well, no worries. Actually, I kind of went a good bit out of my way. Or, like, the potato is culinarily considered a starch because it's a lot of carbohydrates, even if it's technically a vegetable. You know, in the same way, New Vegas is a Bethesda game, even if Bethesda Softworks didn't technically make this, it was made by Obsidian, it has all the markings of a Bethesda open world game. Alright, let's try not to get off track this time. Unless I see a landmark that looks interesting and I want to go explore it. That's what it's all about, after all. Ooh. Another bladed gauntlet. Yes. Not in the best possible condition, but definitely good as a backup. Yeah, 31 damage versus 36. Good enough for me. Sure doesn't look like I'm on a road right now. Uh-oh. What saw me? If you hear a random click occasionally, that's me trying to enter vats to see what enemy is in the vicinity. I'm not seeing these mines at all. I don't remember having such a huge problem seeing them before. I'm thinking it must have something to do with my low perception. These games are so nice to just kind of relax and chill out for a little bit, even though they have the potential to be very stressful. The fact that I can just kind of wander around and look at stuff in between sections of action. You know, there's a reason Skyrim is one of the best-selling games on Steam ever, and still one of the most active games. Just having a world to explore and look around in, and constantly see new stuff. It's very appealing. Hell is this big dome structure up here? Oh god. Okay, well, I probably deserve that. Is that everyone? Ooh, duct tape. I need to fight more vipers. I've noticed a strong correlation in between vipers and duct tape. Alright, let's drink some sarsaparilla here. I might as well use this metal armor, I guess. Decreases my agility -1, but, you know, it can only go so low. What's reducing my endurance? Oh, minor dehydration. Okay.
You for death, and the Legion obeys. Ready yourself for battle.
Oh boy. Man, really? I guess I should have been more judicious with my drug use. I swear to God, I can't do anything without the damn Legion coming in and screwing everything up for me. I'm just gonna have to remember to save more often. Right, I wanna just follow the road here. You know, I don't regret taking out the group of legionnaires, or whatever you want to call them, who torched Nipton to the ground. Is it causing trouble for me? Sure, but you know, they're essentially the Nazis of this game, and you don't just let Nazis get away with that shit if you can help it. Oh good, that bladed gauntlet is still there. I'm never confident about how the randomization works in these games. Like, I never know if saving and loading is gonna cause items to spawn differently, or I mean, with the Caesar's Legion attack, that's pretty much just a random event that, you know, saving and looting will, you know, they're not necessarily going to attack me in the same place. All right, there was a mine around here somewhere. Let's see if I can actually notice it this time. That would be swell. Although I feel like last time I had already stepped on the mine before I approached the bodies of the vipers. Yeah, maybe that mine's not there this time. Who knows? No one's in the chat right now, but that's okay. I appreciate anyone watching this practice stream in the future. Grenade rifle. What the hell is that? Yeah, this metal armor isn't as good as the last one I found. I have never seen a weapon referred to as a grenade rifle before. Always like a grenade launcher. Or maybe an RPG. Rocket propelled grenade. Never seen it referred to as a rifle. Alright, there's gotta be more vipers around here somewhere, right? I think this is a pretty game, in spite of it being a barren wasteland. Like, the landscape and the terrain is interesting to look at. It looks pretty natural. I saw a news story recently, right before I started streaming, about a project where people were trying to remake Fallout 3 in the Fallout 4 engine. And I'm just like, why? What would that add? Like, the Fallout 4 engine is not a huge step above the Fallout 3 engine. And I really don't think the performance hit is worth, you know, what small upgrades you get and graphical fidelity, but that's just me. I always value performance over I don't know what the word is. Energy cells. Very valuable. Worth 2 caps apiece. Hey, Big Greasy. Welcome. It brings new life to the game. I suppose, I mean, if their goal is to get people playing Fallout 3 again and talking about it, then that's one way to do it, but I mean, I don't think Fallout 3 is really that good to begin with anyway, so it's just a baffling decision for me. Now, if they were remaking New Vegas in the engine, then that might be interesting, but not much, Big Greasy. Just kind of hanging out, chilling a little bit, unwinding before bed. But yeah, the project was canceled, apparently because they were running into potential legal issues. Wait a second. Holy crap. I thought this was just a normal meat cleaver. I saw the value of 626 and I was like, wait, I can't be reading that correctly. Doesn't even do that much damage. I don't know why it's that valuable, but I will sell the hell out of that. Swear to God, I think I have the brightness turned up all the way and I still can barely see shit half the time. Wonder how much of a difference changing the texture size would make as far as performance goes. Tumblers today. Magazine all about Sherlock, Doctor Who, anime, and social justice. Reinforced leather armor. Not bad. This was a very lucrative little shack to check out. Fallout 3 garbage lighting system. I mean, it makes sense thematically that everything would be dark, but, you know, that's not good for me to play. I've ranted about this recently. You know, not being able to see things is not fun for me. So even if it's unrealistic, I would rather have better lighting. Also, hey Jane, welcome. Interesting. No real point to this being here, I don't think. Just a little bit of flavor. Actually, I don't know what this whole area is. It's interesting though. This is part of the farm, right? This is just stuff you would see on a farm or a ranch. You beat Far Cry 5, congrats. I still haven't played a Far Cry game. Well, that's not true. I tried playing Blood Dragon a little bit on the 360 and I can't play first person shooters with a controller and, you know, normally Fallout would be no exception, except that I'm doing a no guns run, so I don't have to worry about aiming. I can't aim with a controller. I was able to play Borderlands with a controller because it does this sort of auto-aim thing where when you zoom in with the iron sights, it sort of like magnetizes to the target. So, you know, it's like a little auto-assist aim thing. But, yeah, on the actual console, I didn't enjoy. Or with Blood Dragon, it didn't seem to have that, so I did not enjoy it. Ooh, gunshots. Yeah, that's basically everything I've heard about Far Cry 5, is that the game is solid mechanically and the story is just a big nothing. Oh, traveling merchants. Nice. Wait. What? Oh. I thought they were shooting at me.
Hey there. Need anything?
Depends. What do you got? Of course, I can only sell it for 300, but still, that's pretty good. Again, I should actually see what they have for sale before I start selling everything here. Purified water, jet, dirty water, bitter drink. Hit points plus 4 over 18 seconds. That's not bad, actually. And it only costs 2. Okay, I'll take it. Get me some dynamite, and I'm sure I still have some more stuff to sell here. Grenade rifle. Bad metal armor. Oh, wait. Run the poor guy out of caps. I'll buy an anti-venom. There we go. Very lucrative. You know, you see a lot fewer cars in the post-apocalypse than one might think. I mean, when the bombs fell, well, I don't know, maybe people had time to drive somewhere and prepare for it. Man, shit is popping off. Wonder where they're fighting. Oh, Legionnaires. Well, I have no qualms about swooping in and taking the spoils of war for myself. Throwing spear. And these guys were probably about to come after me. I should just hang out with the merchants. They have a small army with them. Wait, is that recruit helmeted and good? Meh. And I'm just gonna stick by y'all. Except I think you're going the opposite direction from where I need to go. Still though. Oh, no. Change your mind. Heading back this way. Video game graffiti. Yeah, like I was saying, you would think that you would see more cars along the roads here. Oh well. I'm not complaining. Makes life easier for me. Spear uses melee skills, even though you throw it. That kind of makes sense to me. In D&D, thrown weapons typically use the same stats as non-thrown weapons. That's probably a terrible explanation of what I was trying to say, but basically, normally, if you're throwing daggers at someone, it uses your agility stat. But if you're throwing, an axe or a weapon that's normally used in melee, it would still use your strength stat, basically. So if you have a spear, then whether you throw it or stab someone with it, it would still use strength. But weapons that are ranged only would typically use dexterity, at least in 4th edition. I don't know nothing about no other editions of D&D. Except that, I have a tiny little bit of experience with 2nd edition. That's it. Finally, some actual fodder. 5 XP. It's not worth the ding it put in my bladed gauntlet. Oh, great. My favorite friends. Now see, if I had pissed off the powder gangers before this point, then I would have to fight both groups of people at once. But now, since the powder gangers actually like me, sort of, they're sort of helping. Let's see here. See if I can get rid of some of my sickness here. Yeah, food minus 44 for uncooked mole rat meat. That's actually not bad. And let's use a medex. Thanks for your help, fellas. I appreciate it. I swear it felt like the powder gangers were shooting at them a second ago. Let's see if I can draw them out. Oh! These are the people I have to rescue. That makes sense. I didn't realize I was already there. Uh-oh, veteran legionary. Could be trouble. Legion veteran armor. I wonder if I can repair that with any of my, Wow. Yeah, I'm sort of heading in a high crit direction with my perks and everything. Minor starvation. Oh, mole rat meat affects my strength? That sucks. Didn't realize that. But yeah, with my high luck and let's see, Hunter 75% critical. That's against animals though. But I also just in general, I didn't take the more damage but fewer crits thing, which I'm glad I did. Or I'm glad I decided not to do that. NCR outnumbers the Legion in the map. Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. Alright, I'm getting dangerously close to overburdened here. Man, even in full condition, that only gives me 10. Well, I guess my veteran's armor goes well with my helmet, which is totally broken now, but that's okay. Does it still show up on my head? Yeah, that's the important thing. Like, it only gives me a couple points of defense. Oh, I was hoping I could repair my Vexillarius helmet with the recruit helmet, but I guess not. Maybe once it's fully broken, you have to take it to someone to repair it or use an item on it. You can't use other items to bolster it. I guess these are worth hanging on to. So who am I stealing from in this situation? This is a Legionnaire camp, right? Because they had people, you know, they had hostages here. But why would stealing from the Legion be bad? Yeah, that's true. It might not be a good idea to just walk around in Legionary armor. I should probably go back to the NCR camp and have Dude repair my leather armor, just so I don't have to be disguised as a faction. Wait, I thought this was like a workbench or something. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna see what's in these foot lockers, you know. I mean, this clearly belongs to the Legion, so I don't know why I would lose karma by stealing from them, but whatever. Yeah, that's why I took off my NCR armor when I went into NCR territory, because I didn't want to risk someone just getting angry at me or impersonating an NCR. Alright, gonna have to drop something here. Let's see. Once again, I wish I could sort by weight. Damn it. I didn't mean to press that button. I mean, I did, but it was the wrong button to push in that situation. Alright. 1 more pound. I'll just drop one of those. All right. Well, I completed a quest. I liberated some powder gangers. They did not seem too grateful, but you know, I did the right thing, even if the powder gangers aren't necessarily the best people in the world. they still don't deserve to be enslaved or whatever was going on here. They'll use the amount of rep you have rather than, oh, okay, so they won't get mad at me for impersonating an NCR person. They just, you know, I won't get the reputation boost, which is fine. I don't care about my reputation with the NCR anyway. But if I'm walking around dressed as a member of the Legion, I think there's a good chance that I might get capped for that. All right. So yeah, that quest is just complete. I still don't know who gave me that quest or why I had it in my list, but it worked out, I suppose. All right. So let's take care of this one item at a time here. Go to the Mojave Outpost to get my leather armor repaired, so that way I won't have to.
Hey there. Need anything? Sure.
All right, raking in the money. Hi. Excuse me while I make a giant racket.
Been doing a lot of good work out there, setting an example for the others. All right.
Oh boy. That costs way too much for only being a +2 gain in defense. That's like half my money, or that's more than half my money. That's ridiculous.
Sir.
Evening. I wish I could use all this Legionnaire armor to repair my reinforced leather armor, but oh well. I'll just wear my NCR bandolier armor for now.
Something else you wanted?
So yeah, this guy is like super high ranking, so if he's not like,
hey there.
If he's not like making a fuss about me being dressed as the NCR, then I should be okay. Where is this damn layabout? Never behind the counter where he should be. Sleeping! At 11:38 p.m.? What's wrong with you? I need to sell all of my garbage. Buy some supplies? What is... Hang on, sorry. Okay, sorry about that.
And
I have this program running called Push Bullet, which basically shows all of the notifications on my phone, on my computer, and I always forget to turn it off before I stream, and it always ends up showing me a bunch of garbage. Covering up the chat, which is the main bummer about it. Alright, definitely want to keep all this. We can sell that and that. Sell all of these. Oh, Tumblers Today is a book? Nice. Do you actually have anything I want? All the garbage I already sold you. I'll take that doctor's back.
Thanks.
Right. Now I'll go talk to the doc and buy some stim packs, hopefully. Assuming he's fully restocked. Look at that lazy fucker just going back to bed. I could rob this dude blind. Who sleeps at midnight? And a weirdo does that. The broken leg NPC in Nipton. Oh, so I guess because I talked to that guy and he told me about the hostages that they took, it just kind of resulted in me getting that quest. That makes sense. Oh. Ooh. He actually has, like, supplies to make stim packs, which is nice. Phew. I think I need surgical tubing as well. I could probably buy some of those stim packs, I guess. I'll buy 5 of them. There we go. I don't know why it keeps doing that. It keeps... My pause button must be broken or something. Right, and I'll set that to down instead of the Super Stim Pack. Save my Super Stim Pack for when I need it more. I mean, really, anytime I can just pop into my menu and use any of this stuff. Oh, right, Cheyenne. Okay. I was like, wait. Did dog meat just show up? Does the doctor have a chemistry station? Because if he does, I can make meds and stuff there. Oh, there's also some more stuff here for me to take. Yeah, he does. Okay. Oh. Weird. Oh, it was a binary choice. I thought it would be like the crafting menu. Oh well, I got 5 stem packs out of it. I guess that's something. Boy, playing this with my own music is a different experience, too. I kind of like it. I mean, I like a lot of the music in the Fallout games. There's just not nearly enough of it. And when you hear the same whatever songs repeated over and over again, and, you know, always the same style of songs, it can get pretty grating, to be honest. And of course, you don't have to listen to the radio, but then you get like the weird ambient music, which is also kind of dull and repetitive. And if you turn that off, then you just have silence. Which honestly, silence might be cool for this kind of game. I don't know, but I'm enjoying listening to my dope jams. I really don't have a go-to spot for making drugs and stim packs and stuff. I mean, I have the ingredients to make at least some of it. Like, if there's a campfire around here, I don't know where it is. Maybe what's-his-face at the gas station knows. Maybe I should actually talk to that guy. I forget where that is. Man, I could go for another one of these. Like, a good one. Not a Fallout 4. Hey, friend.
That's close enough. Who are you, and what do you want with me? Sorry about the gun. You just caught me off guard, that's all. We got off to a bad start. Let's say we start over with a friendly game of Caravan. You know how to play?
I will never know how to play Caravan.
Yeah, he doesn't look very tough, though. I hear he's afraid I'll shoot him down from one of the windows when I see him. And he's right. I'll have a much bigger problem once his friends show up. There's no way I could handle all of them in a gunfight. My caravan was on the return trip from California and heading back to the company branch in New Vegas when we got jumped. Not even a drop your weapons and hands up before the bullets started flying. We put up a good fight, but there was too many of them. I took a few of the bandits down before I ran. So I figure their friends are out for revenge. I'm gonna lay low for as long as I can, assuming the town doesn't throw me to the wolves. I've got no chance against the gang on my own. All I've got left on me are a handful of caps, but you get me out of this and I'll make sure the Crimson Caravan pays you back. You've got my word. We just end up sharing the same grave if it's just the two of us.
Oh, right. So,
if some of the other people in town were also on board. I was thinking of myself, actually. Who's gonna watch my back while I'm watching yours? Start with Sunny Smiles. She's been friendlier than most around here.
Yeah, to do this quest, I have to go around.
What's going on? Did Sunny agree to help us?
I didn't push a button on you. Alright, I have a book to read. Lockpick increased by 3. Because, you know, I'm super into the whole lockpicking thing this run. I am playing this from a fresh restart, and it is noticeably better. Smoother. Of course, I'm streaming out at 30 frames per second, so you probably don't notice it on your end, but it's a noticeable improvement for me. Yeah, this guy doesn't know shit. He wouldn't know shit from Shinola. Whatever that is. So I can take anything I want in this gas station, but as soon as I try to steal his ammo, oh, that's stealing. You know, ammunition, the most important thing in the world. In Fallout. Except for me. Because I got my fists. And I'm sure that I could take on a group of powder gangers at this point without enlisting the help of the town. And that's boring and I don't want to do all that, so let's see. I've been meaning to go back and see if I can do anything with Eddie yet. I think Fallout New Vegas is not responding. Okay. I thought it crashed, but it was just having a was having an unpleasant load experience. Science 55. I'm almost there. I love this track. Yeah, this is one of those times when having a magazine would actually come in handy. Because I only need like 5 points of science to repair it. Not even that, 3 points. Oh well, I'll come back. I am in no hurry. Alright, so yeah, best bet probably heading up the road from the Legion Raid camp. Missiles. That's a hell of a thing to find in a sack. Oh yeah, there's a campfire here. Can I not make stim packs at a campfire? Suppose not. Oh, I didn't see this guy. Yeah, I mean that's a really irresponsible thing to set there. Just a sack full of missiles. Are you guys noticing any reduced latency? I'm using the beta low latency thing that Twitch started doing. At least I think I am. It did seem like Levant responded to the missile find faster than people were responding to stuff last stream. Although it could be my imagination. So yeah, I think I need a chemistry set, and I think the thing in the doctor's house wasn't an actual chemistry set. It was like an event I could trigger. And I need whatever the crafting version of that is. Let's make a hard save. Haven't done that recently. Alright, I'm actually heading the wrong direction. Oh, more of a tutorial thing, yeah. So you would see that there, and you would realize that, hey, my skills affect what I have the ability to do. That makes sense. So it seems like the disguise mechanic is more about infiltration than like faction fighting. Like I actually don't know if someone sees me dressed as a member of the Legion, if that would affect me. Who the hell is this person on my map or on my compass? Was it that bird that just flew away? It looked like there was a person right around here. I guess it was the bird. Bye, bird. Man, I was going to head off in a direction and look at some landmarks. Which I guess yeah, why not? I'm in no hurry to get to Novak and progress the main story quest. Go look at some triangles. You guys want to see some triangles? Are you interested in some triangulation? Pick the prickly pear. Peter Piper picked a pear of prickly pickles. Wrong button. Doesn't look like I'll be able to Skyrim my way over these mountains. Oh well. Walking Box Cavern. Well, I might as well take a look at what horrors lurk within. And who knows, it might not be horrors. There might be some people here chilling out. But judging by the appearance of this place, I am expecting horrors. You know, hope for the best, expect the worst. Hope for friends, expect abominations. All these mushrooms I can't pick. Ooh, I remember these things not being good. Especially not when there's like fucking 10 of them. I am not expecting to get out of this alive. Let's use a super stim pack, turbo, medics. I mean, I might as well just try everything I can to Even with maximum druggage, I wasn't able to get through that. Alright, I'll be back for you, Night Stalkers. Don't you worry. Those puppers did give me a heckin' frightin'. Those things are creepy. They're like big dog lizards. Yeah, the Night Stalkers are one of the enemies I remember giving me trouble even in the late game. There's some interesting enemies in this game along the margins. Like up in some parts of the mountains, there are these horrible flying little mini pterodactyl things. Well, you know what, Jane? I'm happy for you. You probably had guns as well. I mean, the main problem with Night Stalkers is that you never get attacked by just one or two. It's always like 12. Yeah, the poison bugs, those things are nasty. Yeah, it says right there, strength minus one. Ooh. Hey, Vipers. Where are these guys even blowing me up with? I don't know. Should probably drink some water and eat some food while I'm at it. Bet you're hit. Oh, that's what they were shooting me with, a grenade rifle. That's why there were explosions happening. Yeah, I don't remember grenade rifles at all. Man, I know I saw Stimpak as something that I could potentially make. And I thought it was at a campfire, but I guess not. Because I remember needing empty syringes. And now I actually have a couple.